lecture, we are going to analyze the first model for the inventory management, that is the reorder point model. This model takes into account one item at a time, and it is based on the order of a custom quantity queue, which is issued when the inventory availability goes under a fixed value, the so-called reorder point quantity. Once the order of queue pieces is performed, we need to wait a certain replenishment lead time in order to receive the products. Under the assumption of demand and lead time predictability, the expected inventory level in the warehouse, intended as the physical quantity on hand, follows a path according to which there are, first, an increase of the inventories of a quantity equal to Q when the order is received. Then a progressive decrease of the inventories in the warehouse till the moment in which the next order is received. Therefore, if we do not consider demand and lead time uncertainty, the maximum inventory level is equal to Q, and the minimum inventory level is equal to zero. As stated at the beginning of the lecture, the orders are issued when the availability goes under the reorder point. The availability represents the virtual quantity on hand. In fact, the availability also includes the amount of goods that have already been ordered but still did not enter the warehouse. The expected path of the availability is the same of the inventory level but shift both horizontally and vertically. Horizontally, because the availability increases when the order takes place, not when the products enter the warehouse. So the availability increases before the physical inventory, and the horizontal distance between the two paths is the replenishment lead time. Vertically, because the orders are placed when the inventory level reaches the reorder point quantity, and so the maximum availability is higher than the maximum physical inventory. At the time the order is issued, the availability increases by a quantity equal to Q. Therefore, the maximum availability is equal to the reorder point plus the order quantity Q. The minimum level of the availability instead is equal to the reorder point. Up to now, we have assumed, for the sake of simplicity, that the demand and the lead time are predictable. However, the demand and the lead time are usually not precisely predictable, and thus it is necessary to add to the regular stocks also the so-called safety stocks that allow to protect in by stockout. In fact, we need additional inventories because the demand could be higher than expected, or the lead time could be higher than expected, or a combination of these two situations. We will see in the next lectures how to define the safety stocks on the basis of the desired customer service level. Therefore, in order to consider the uncertainty, we need to change the graphs we have previously seen for the expected inventory level and the expected availability. More specifically, they should be moved up of a quantity equal to the safety stocks. In order to adopt the reorder point model, two parameters must be defined. First, the order quantity Q, which is connected to the cycle stocks. We will see how to define the economic order quantity, that is the quantity that minimizes the total costs, in the next video clips. The second parameter is the reorder point quantity, which is instead connected to the safety stocks. Focusing on the reorder point quantity, it can be calculated as the sum of two quantities, the expected demand during the replenishment lead time and the average value of the safety stocks. This quantity allows indeed to meet the demand during the lead time, that is during the time between the order issue and the order received, assuming a certain service level. Considering the average inventory level, it is equal to the sum of the average value of the safety stocks and the average value of the cycle stocks. Since in the reorder point model, the cycle stocks ranges from 0 to Q, the average value of the cycle stocks is half the order quantity Q.